Having some trouble, man. I need to fasten this to my helmet a little bit better.
All's I've got is tape. What do you want to do?
Fasten it? Yeah.
Like how?
I don't know. Like let's drill some holes in this puppy and
drill holes in your helmet.
Yeah.
I've got a drill and some drill bits and some zip ties. If you want to do it like that.
Let's do that.
Okay.
If you can't fix it with zip ties, what's the point? Don't scratch my paint.
Oh gosh, and you're gonna drill a hole in it. Okay, that'll be alright. You can go through the cushion.
You need that cushion.
Or my finger.
Hubert, you're like the Martha Stewart of fixing things.
Well, I didn't really want to drill your helmet. Like,
well, you did.
But if you're okay with it.
But you didn't. I was born with one of these in my hand, bro. Daddy was a contractor.
This man ain't scared to drill a helmet.
Nope.
Your helmet's good now.
Thanks, man.
It should be pretty solid. But when we're done, I need those wires back out of it. Put in another helmet.
He thinks he's getting it back. Totally mine now.
All right, we're rolling into day 8. We're leaving Butte, Montana, and we're gonna head down over to Ibex, the clutch company we work with. And really, this is a big day. We're a little behind, and we gotta go 240 miles today. Yeah, I think we need to giddy up. I think we're still in Montana. I'm not really sure where we're at. We're just following the GPS line. I know we're going through this mountain range and then we come out by the interstate. So I'm estimating we're maybe an hour from the interstate. And the locals said there are quite a few grizzlies in this mountain range area. So I know Tommy would love to see a grizzly bear.
Tell you what, you see a bear, you better tell that bear you better look out for me.
Road conditions are poopy. There's poop everywhere. That's mostly like this stuff, poop. Poop, poop. Flew up, got them back, got poop on my poop. Got poop in the poop. Poop, poop, poop.
Amazing.
Poopity poop. Oh, poop, yeah. Poop, poop. Yeah. This is all poop. That is poop.
Almost there! You see the mountain range in front of us? We're almost there!
Yeah, we're almost there.
We're not! Almost there!
I wish to God it was planned.
It is planned.
It ain't planned. That thing, look inside my cab right now, says 212 miles. It ain't no buck 40.
The mileage wasn't planned, but point to point was planned.
Well, oh man, thanks Captain Obvious. The point to point was planned.
Yeah.
We're still out here.
Made it to American Falls, Idaho from the border basically a little more than a week ago. We're at the shop of Ibex, who I work with on clutch kits and such as that. They make a twin turbo kit like what's on that machine.
What kind of Can-Am is that right there?
That's a harvester.
Oh, it's a Can-Am harvester.
Yeah.
Got it.
So yeah, Ibex is known for clutch kits, power upgrades, and clutch parts and tools and such as that. And we got some pretty cool things in store with some pretty big stuff.
All right, so we're getting ready to race these combines, and everything that I've seen, they're pretty slow. So they don't really have us going that far. And I'm gonna win, I'm a better driver. But for some reason, if this tractor just, he gave me the slow one for some reason, I'm gonna beat him on foot. I got something up my sleeve.
face! In your face! You suck!
Hey y'all, here we are. 10 days in by the calendar. And roughly over 1,000 miles in by the mileage. Yesterday we went from Pocatello to Logan, Utah. I scheduled it roughly probably about 140 to 180 miles, but it wasn't that, I don't think.
All right, so he's just throwing out a ton of math that I feel like is not really correct anywhere. I've been having a good time. We're in Utah. Let's see if we can get to Park City.
So we're doing border-to-border ride. We stopped through Park City, Utah, and in that area is happens to be home of a good friend, Ken Block.
So we have 115 acres here.
Oh, yeah.
And it backs up on two major sides to basically BLM, Bureau of Land Management land. So we can ride directly off our property in the summer onto like UTV trails, dirt bike trails, single tracks.
Yeah.
And in the winter, it's all then snowmobile access back here. But the 115 acres though, we've got three mountain bike trails. We got a 1.2 mile outdoor track. We're putting in a cross car track. We've got a stream, a pond. Came with a cabin, a log cabin built in the 70s. So now we're building more garages. So yeah, it's kind of paradise for the things that we like to do.
All right, Ken, I really want to thank you for just giving us a quick little tour of your family paradise here. The place is unreal.
Unreal.
It's got a little bit of everything. I can see why you don't really want to ever leave home.
Kitchen dad.
Well, Ken, thank you so much for the tour. We got another 2,000 miles to go. We're going to barbecue, then Arizona, then Mexico. So if you want to go, just follow along.
Yeah, I wish you.
Well, thanks for the time. See y'all soon.
Later, dude.
Thank you.